What's up, Mason here on the Synthedelic Channel. This time it's going to be a Megadeth tone, Peace Sells, but who's buying? I hadn't actually heard this album before starting to make this tone. I did a live stream where I listened to it for the first time. You hear all that reverb? That's a lot of reverb. I had obviously heard Peace Sells before, but that was the only song off the album that I'd heard. The biggest thing with this guitar tone is it sounds super different depending on where you have the microphone. Unless you have the microphone in the perfect spot, it's not going to sound like how their recordings sound. It's kind of off-center, a little farther to the left. I'll throw up a graphic of where it is. I'm sorry for the large gap between my last video and this one. I've had a whole lot of stuff going on. This December has been crazy for me. This video is in dedication to my girlfriend's cat that just passed away. So I'm gonna have three different tones in the download for this patch. I'm gonna have the main rhythm distortion and the lead distortion, which is basically the same thing, just a little bit tweaked around. And for the leads, you probably would wanna move the mic more over the cone. And then a clean tone. But the clean tone is pretty much the same one as the last Megadeth one that I did. But here's what the main distortion sounds like. Here's the lead tone. And this is the clean that I used in Bad Omen. I put my guitar on the split middle and humbucker position. So let's hop into the Tone Studio and see what I got going for this one. So I started with the R-Fire Vintage Sneaky Amp. It's supposed to be a Mesa Boogie Dual Rectifier in vintage mode, but I think it just sounds like a Katana. And with 32 on the gain, 73 bass, 38 middle, 52 treble, 31 presence with a deep cabinet resonance, with my Yellow System EQ, which is this right here. This is how it sounds with no effects being added. I'm using chain 2-2 so that I can have an extra EQ after the amp. For the booster, I got the Senta OD with the drive at 43, the tone at 35, the bottom at minus 50, and the effect level at 60. With that, it sounds like this. This album doesn't have too much gain. You can really notice it in the Peace Sells when they're doing the palm mutes for after the intro section. Like that even might be too much, but the EQ after this will take away some more. In the mod spot, I have a graphic EQ with this zigzaggy pattern with the level on minus 6, taking out the sub bass so that you don't have such a boomy palm mute. Taking away 4K so you don't have a whistly sound in there, and adding 16K and 8K a little bit to get more of that crisp top end when you do palm mutes. In the effects spot, I have this parametric EQ, 63 hertz low cut plus 1 low gain, minus 3 dB at 315 hertz with the Q at 8, plus 5 dB at 800 hertz with the Q at 1. No high cut, the high gain is at plus 1, the level is on plus 1. With that, it sounds like this. The next EQs will tame out those mids a little bit. Not using this first delay. I am using the second delay as a doubler. A lot of the songs on this album, you hear that flangey subtleness going on. A lot of the time,
It doesn't even sound like it's a really a stereo guitar double track. It just sounds like one guitar with this on it. Some of the songs. So I have this set up here with the modulate delay with the delay time on 12 milliseconds. Mod rate pretty low and the mod depth pretty low. Effect level on 44. Here's just what this sounds like. In the reverb spot, I have plate reverb with the reverb time on 1.7 seconds, no pre-delay, the low cut on 315, the high cut on 6.3, zero on the density, and the effect level's on 90. Here's just the reverb. Here's both. I'm using the solo for the solo EQ, the level on zero, the low cut at 80, the low gain being boosted by 0.5. At 250 hertz, I'm taking away 4 dB with the Q at 8, 8K high cut, taking away 1.5 dB of high gain, and the position is set to amp out. With that, it sounds like this. I'm using Contour Type 2 with the frequency shift at 25. That kind of scoops the mids but shapes them a little bit so where they're not overly scooped. An EQ 1 here. I have a parametric EQ set to amp out. I have a low cut at 63 Hz, taking away 630 Hz by 7 dB with the Q at 4. At 1K, I'm taking away 8 dB with the Q at 4. I have a high cut at 10K, boosting the high gain by plus 1 and the level by plus 1. And with that, it sounds like this. In the second EQ spot here, low cut at 63 Hz again. At 160 Hz, I'm taking away 8 dB with the Q at 8. At 8K, I'm taking away 6 dB with the Q at 4. I have a high cut at 10K, taking away 1 dB of high gain, boosting the level up by plus 1. Noise suppressor is on 50, release on 0. That is the tone. I'll quickly go through the clean and the lead. The lead is basically the same as the main patch. It's just got more gain. The bass is a little bit lower. The middle is a bit higher. The treble's around the same. Presence is around the same. It's got all the same effects. This first delay I'm using as a like echo, like a short echo. This second delay is doing the same thing it was. The reverb is the exact same. The drive on the booster is up significantly. And for the clean, it's basically the one I've been using. I like it so much. I think it sounds good for every situation. And it really blends well with the clean sound that they already used on this album for stuff like Bad Omen. It's more of an acoustic sound, but I feel like if you use your middle pickup or combine the two, it sounds pretty good. I left the mic in the same spot for the sound demos. It's right here. I just recorded the whole walkthrough and forgot to turn that camera on. So it's just this camera for the walkthrough, I guess. But here's the sound demos. Thank you. So I won this guitar at in a bar giveaway, and I'm gonna make a video about it soon, talking about things I would improve on it and fixing it up and stuff. But I figured maybe I can show what this tone will sound like on a single coil guitar that's an E standard, not 425 hertz E. But here's what the patch sounds like on a different guitar. Since this is a single coil, I think it could use a little more gain. Add it there and a little bit more here. Guitar doesn't hold a tune very well right now. So let me know what you think of the tone down in the comments. If you download this tone and you're really happy with it, leave a like on the video if you thought it was pretty good. You can use them for whatever you want, I don't care. But yeah, thanks for watching this video, and until the next one.
You're beautiful.